Shepparton has spent the past few months in and out of lockdowns.
And these things happen because people aren't abiding by the health rules very often.
Late last night, the regional city had its freedoms revoked.
And I really want to apologise to the whole community in Shepparton. Of course, we do that with a heavy heart.
It's in a seven-day lockdown as active cases balloon to 34 on the back of an illegal AFL grand final party last weekend. There are now 71 cases across regional Victoria and four areas are in lockdown, along with Greater Melbourne. Victoria recorded 1,488 new cases today, its highest number of the pandemic, and two deaths. 429 people are in hospital, 97 of those are in ICU, and 54 of them are on ventilators. The construction industry will get back on the tools on Monday after a two-week shutdown caused by worksite virus outbreaks, a public tantrum over tea rooms being closed, and finally, violent street protests. Now the state government has allocated the industry $196.6 million in business support. But the Treasurer is furious the package isn't being matched by the federal government.
Make no mistake, this is churlishness, this is mean-spirited behaviour. And it hurts an industry that doesn't deserve this treatment.
Data shows New South Wales received more than $6 billion in disaster payments compared to $2.4 billion in Victoria.
If the Prime Minister wants us to stop calling him the Prime Minister for New South Wales, well, he has to stop acting like it.
Candace Wyatt for 10 News First.